Hello, my crafty friends, and welcome back to another Mixed Media Tuesday. Today I'm going for a double spread in my creative art journal, and my goal today is to show you how you can easily make an art journal without even having to create a background with your mediums. So for my background, I will play with paper. And I had this older Serre Vagabond collection in my stash, so I will use one of the scrapbook papers that look like old pages. If you want to create something similar and you don't have this scrapbook paper, no worries, you can simply use two pages from a book. After cutting it out, you can see that it is quite big and it would cover the whole page. However, I don't want that. I want to make it more interesting to the eye. That's why I will make sure that it is slightly smaller than the two pages, leaving a border all around. And it's also too wide, that's why I will cut it in half, and I will also chop off a little bit from the center. I'm distressing the edges with my tool there. If you don't have such a tool, you can easily use your scissors and go around the edges for that. And I'm only distressing the three edges, the outside ones. I'm not going to bother at all with the one that goes in the middle, where the spine of the book is. Don't forget to like, to leave me a comment, and also hit that bell to make sure that you get a notification whenever I post a new video. These are just a few ways to support my channel so that I can share even more. All I'm doing here is just using some pattern paper that I had in my stash and just cutting off strips of paper. I'm also going to cut out a few vellum strips and I will use all of them for layering. So let's work on those notebook pages and make them look more interesting. I'm starting by stamping all over those pages. I'm using black archival ink and just a stamp that I had for years, which has some script text on top. And while I'm doing that, let's discuss a little bit about art journaling. I get a lot of questions and comments about art journaling and how difficult it may be to start on a blank page. But there are many tricks on how you can do that. You can always start with sticking down rice paper, or you can just go like I did today by using a scrapbook page that you already have in your stash. Always remember that when we do art journaling, we are just having fun with layers. Don't be bothered if you cover up a layer that you did previously. It's just the process that is really fun. Don't worry at all if you don't like how the completed project looks. If you did have fun while playing with your mediums, your paste, your stencils, your brushes, while you were creating your layers, then you definitely reached your goal. Art journaling is all about having some creative time with yourself, with your mediums, just to relax and not to bring you any anxiety of how this is going to look. Always remember, these are nicely hidden inside your book. At the end of the day, you'll just close it and no one will ever see it. It's not a canvas for everyone else to criticize. So just have fun in your journal and you will see that the more you create, the more you will find your very own style and you will end up liking your finished projects. So back to the project, after doing all the stamping, I did ink up the edges with distress ink, and that's ground espresso, and I'm doing that both for my two pages, which are my main background, as well as for all those pieces that I will use to layer, even for the vellum. I just want to have a little tint of that brown color on all of my pieces, which is a little detail that brings all the elements together. Using the same color of ink, I am going to add some splashes on both those pages. And now I will create my layers just by sticking all those strips of paper, one on top of the other. I want that vellum on both edges so that it helps that piece of paper to stand against the background even more. That's why I'm sticking it on both edges. And I will place that on my background again by using glue. Since these are going to go inside my art journal book, I don't want to have too much bulk. If I was working on a canvas or even on a disc bound journal, I could add even more dimension by using some foam tape at the back. I'm using my scissors to cut off the excess paper. And now let's add more interest by adding different textures on the page. I'm using some thread and I'm going to wrap it around those layers of paper. Wrap it around as many times as you like, and I made sure that the thread I'm using is quite thin, so it's not going to add too much bulk. And I will just secure the ends at the back with a piece of tape. And I'm lighting up a candle. I'm planning to add a wax seal on my page. It is a really fun technique, and I don't know why I haven't used it up to now on my art journals. The seal is quite thin, it doesn't add bulk inside the book. It's a really interesting element that draws the eye, and at the same time it adds a different texture. And while my wax is melting, I'm just inking up a few scrap pieces so that I can create a little cluster. Now, there are different types of waxes that you can use for creating wax seals. You can even make your own with your silicone gun if you want to. I went with those little beads. I find them really easy to work with, and just use four of them in that little spoon. That makes it really handy to use, since I can work on something else while my wax is melting on top of that tea light. So I keep on using scrap pieces of paper, and if you are wondering, these papers come from a collection by Stamperia, which is called Calligraphy. Now my wax is melted, and I'm going to add a little blob. I don't want my seal to be perfect, that's why I added only a little bit, and I make sure that I apply the seal kind of offset. I like to see the imperfections on a wax seal. I kind of feel that it looks more authentic. That's why I went that route. However, if you want, you can even create that seal on top of your glass mat. And when you are happy with the result, you can just peel it off from the glass mat and stick it on top of your project. Although it's not going to embed those threads and stick on top of those papers so nicely. And now let's embellish these two pages with flowers. For today I'm going to work with my Transfer Me pages, and these have lovely, realistic looking flowers. I love the colors because they match nicely with my wax seal, and I'm going with those dark reds as well as some pinks and a few white ones. Those Transfer Me images are from Dress My Craft. They are really inexpensive, and there is a huge collection of images that you can play with. They make great embellishments for art journals, as well as backgrounds or even focal points. So all I did was to separate the flowers and the leaves that I want to play with. And these kind of work like rub-ons, but with water. I did use them previously on my videos, and you probably are familiar with them. However, since I do have lots of layers, I don't want to transfer it directly on my page. So instead, I'm going to transfer all the images on a white piece of paper. So I'm just peeling off the plastic cover. They are kind of sticky, so I'm sticking them down on my white cardstock. And then I'm going to apply water. I'm using here my spray bottle, but you can definitely work with a sponge. The more you wet them, the more that paper on top is going to become transparent. You will be able to see what's underneath, and that's when you know that these are nicely wet and they have transferred on top of your paper. So I am going to lightly slide that top paper, and you can see the beautiful result. The fun part is that these images are transparent all around, so they are not going to give you a halo if you transfer them directly on your project. And I will do that later on, so you will be able to see that as well. If you find that one paper doesn't slide off, don't force it, just apply a little bit of more water on top. So I fuzzy cut all the images, and now I have lovely embellishments. I'm making sure that I get rid of that white edge. For the white flowers, I'm going with brown on the edges. For the leaves, which are darker, as well as for the dark red flowers, I did go with a black marker. And now it's time to place everything down. I'm going to put on some music so you can see how I created my composition, and I will catch you back in a bit. I am also going to use some extra leaves, and this time I will transfer them directly on my project. Here I have no layers, so I can easily do the transfer. This time I don't want to soak the whole page with water, so I'm staying away from my spray bottle. Rather, I apply the water directly on top of the transfer pieces with my brush. And of course, this is a better looking technique than the one that I did previously by sticking them on white page and then cutting them out. First of all, it is quicker, but I couldn't do that previously because I had so many layers. But this time, just because this is transparent, it's going to allow you to see what's underneath, so you don't actually cover up all that stamping, which is a great look for an art journal. So I'm going to stick down those flowers as well. And notice that I don't bother to apply glue all the way at the back. This allows me to be able to tuck underneath other flowers and leaves later on. And placing those flowers down isn't so random as it looks. I actually put a lot of thought on that. You will notice that on each page I have one flower from each style, so I repeat the composition. And since I love that transparent look that I got on those leaves that I did the transfer me directly on the page, I want to recreate that on the rest of the cutouts. That's why I'm going to stamp with the same stamp, but on top of those flowers that aren't transparent anymore. I feel like this little detail really brings all the elements together. And before I stick those two pages on top of my art journal, I am going to cover up the border, whatever is going to show, with black acrylic paint. I even apply a little bit at the spine in case something is going to show in between. And then I can stick my pages down. At this stage, you can call this layout done. However, I'm having so much fun when I'm playing with my mediums that I don't want to stop, and I keep on adding little details upon details. So this layout is no exception. Here I'm embellishing the border a little bit by just sticking a few leaves coming out from behind the pages. I also felt like I wanted to add something extra on the border, that's why I brought in that wax. This is metallic wax and the color is vintage gold. I'm going to apply it around the border with my finger. I'm doing that completely randomly. You will see on some areas I will have more wax than other areas, but I absolutely love that look. It looks more random and more organic. The project was looking so beautiful as it was, and I was debating at this stage on whether I want to use my white gel pen or not, but you know what? It makes me happy, so I'm going to bring it in, and I don't care how the end is going to look like. And that kind of proves my point of do what you love and don't care about the outcome. Also notice that the fun part about using the white gel pen over the TransferMe images is that you can easily wipe it off with your finger if you don't like what you did, and also it writes beautifully on top of it. I have enough blank space to add the quote if I want a bigger one, however I love those big flowers and I didn't want a bigger element to steal their thunder. That's why I decided to go with little sticker quotes. I went with "Be brave with your life, be fearless," and these are from a booklet with sticker quotes by Tim Holtz. These are really old ones that I have in my stash. They are discontinued and not easy to find anymore, but you can easily print out your quotes and stick them down. Of course, I did add some white splashes, and I'm going to show you how you can add some shadows to help those flowers pop even more. I'm going to go around the outside edge, and I'm using ground espresso with water. This is going to work as a watercolor. You can go around your flowers with that and add a little bit of shadow. I usually do that with my big brush markers when I'm working on a non-porous surface, but since this is just paper, it is porous, so the best way to go is with your watercolors. To make your life easy when you are doing shadows, just because you want them to be quite soft, make sure that you don't load too much pigment on your brush and you have lots of water so that you can easily spread it out. And that's it for today. I'm going to call this page done. I'm absolutely happy with the result. Love those layers. Love playing with ready-made images and papers. You see, I didn't even use stenciling or my go-to techniques for the background. Paper did the job beautifully. So I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment and like the video. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.